family in this tribe and put it together as a huge super family. They are actin-based motor proteins, and I was dealing with only this one slide segment of the family. All myosins appear to have the same ATPase or approximately the same ATPase mechanism, but we don't really have time to go into details. So just look at this image. The whole ATPase cycle can be described in these forms. Every step of the cycle can be characterized by this K constant, which is a reaction constant. It describes us how the reaction, how fast is the reaction. Okay, so myosin 16 was discovered by Patel and his co-workers in 2001. It was discovered in rat embryos in the first or after the first second postnatal weeks. And based on their suggestions or the findings, it is suggested that this myosin 16 plays a role in neuronal development. Actually, we don't really know much of their function, but since it appeared during the evolution of mammals or in the mammals, we think that it appeared to perform specific functions. Later on, Cameron and his co-workers did a very good experiment. They transfected COS7 cell lines and they found out that this myosin 16 overexpression caused the cells to be stuck in the S phase. So based on this, they thought that it has some role in the cell hyperregulation. Also, it is probably have something to do with signal transduction, but I will explain that in the next slide. After that, I would like to mention that many of the myosin isoforms have many functions in the brain, and they already know that a lot of mutations can cause several neuronal disorders. And this myosin 16 was detected in schizophrenia patients. In them, myosin 16 was overexpressed. In several autism cases, they found out there was some mutation or deletion in the sequence. And a few years ago, they found out methylation deficiencies in bipolar disorders. So this is how myosin 16 looks like. There is the motor domain, the right chain, the trigger domain, and this was my instrument. This is myosin 16 ankyrin domain. This myosin 16 molecule is unique because of this ankyrin domain. This is the only myosin containing this ankyrin repeat on its head domain. Actually, this repeat is a 33 amino acid residue motif, which can be found all out eukaryotic. It is relatively conserved, it looks like this. It is made of alpha helix, loop alpha helix bundles connected by these beta terms, in which the two alpha helices are arranged in an antiparallel fashion. This motif is exclusively functions to mediate protein-protein interactions. So, we had several questions to be answered in my group. First, we are interested does the myosin ankyrin domain bind directly to the myosin motor domain? Then how does this myosin ankyrin domain influence the motor function? And later on, we were interested how does it influence the ATPase activity and which of these ATPase cycle steps can be altered by this domain. I used several methods. First of them was the purification of the recombinant protein. As you can see here, it was nicely expressed. It was quite high concentration. It was expressed as a recombinant protein, the GSPM. Then I used image chromatography assays. The basis of this assay looks like this. We have a perversive, then myosin head attachment, and then some fluorescent labeled active light elements slide it over. And this method is really good because we can use, investigate single moving active elements, as we will see later. But sadly, we don't have the myosin motor domain itself. So we used a model system, we used conventional myosin 2 by mild digestion. which of us processes, we should step back a little into the world of micro and milliseconds. I used this platform machine for several experiments. This is the basis. We have two solutions which could be mixed. Then flow to the optical cell, which is illuminated. We can measure absorbance, fluorescence in a microsecond, millisecond range. So let's use some results. First, this slide shows us that the myosin-16 actin domain nicely connected to the S1 subfragment, also to the heavy myosin as well. I thought I'd show you this because this connection was stronger. And then we performed a static state ATPase assay, which showed us that it increases the ATPase activity. This shows the basal activity, and these are these when we added some myosin activity to the system. This will be, these are IVME experiments. These were the control when there was no myosin-16 actin domain added to the system. And as you can see, even at smaller concentration, the result is visible, and it's even more remarkable when more myosin-actin domain was added to the reaction. Some numbers, because it's slight numbers. Okay, I perform another series with different ATP concentration, and as you can see, this also showed us really nice results. Based on this, we concluded that the myosin-16 actin domain sensitizes the myosin for the ATP. Then we were interested what the step of the ATPase cycle is altered by this myosin-16 actin domain. We suggested that somehow the ATP dissociation is the one. We performed an experiment when, with a stapler machine when only S1 fragment was incubated with the myosin-16 actin domain and simple myosin molecule. We had ATP motility in the system. And shot through or shot with ATP, so it was a dissociation reaction. And as you can see, there was no change in the reaction. But when we used